Hello everyone, welcome to Lee Dynasty Kitchen. Today I'm going to share with you one of the popular Vietnamese dish called pork sausage. In Vietnamese we call giá lúa. This pork sausage you can eat with some of the dish like rice roll cake, viet sup, and some of the soup. So today, I'm going to share with you how easy and fast to make pork sausage. So come on into the kitchen. So we'll find out in a minute, see how fast and easy to do it. These are all the ingredients we need to make pork sausage. So we're going to need 2.5 pounds of regular ground pork, 200 grams of pork fat, 39 grams of sugar, sea salt, we need 14 grams. Ansa baking powder, we need 5 grams. And we need cornstarch, 20 grams. Fish sauce, 4 grams. And garlic, chopped garlic, 15 grams. All these ingredients, we're going to mix in the bowl and then we're going to stir it up with the pork. So first of all, we're going to put all these ingredients in the small bowl and add 4 spoons of water. This size of the spoon, so 4 spoons of water. Mix it up nice well to all the ingredients, mix all, and then pour it on top of the meat. So we're going to get ready to mix well the pork and the all these ingredients. So of course we're gonna use glove to do because the meat is quite cold, so we can mix all the ingredient to the meat just like the way I'm doing like this. Okay, so mix all to make sure the pork, the pork fat, and the ingredient, everything, mix well together. Just a few minutes. And then after that, we're gonna just, lift up the meat and then throw down to the bowl for a few times. So to make the meat more tight together, right? 2.5 pounds of the ground pork today. We're gonna make 3 pork sausages. Very good, very clean, and very cheap. Tasty, very good. So you find some of this in the different of the Vietnamese food we eat together with pork sausage. So after we mix the meat well, and then we're gonna divide in 3 little small portion like this. I'm gonna make it thin because after we put this in the freezer, so we're gonna for couple hours. So to make sure it's get hard, and then we're gonna grind it. So just 3 little flat portion like this. Don't have to be too fussy about the rubbing. It's just temporary one, so we can freeze them before we make the pork sausage. So 3 of them today, we're gonna make 3 pork sausages, very, very delicious. Okay, so after we're done, we're gonna put all in the freezer. These are the 3 pieces of the meat. I wrap it up, it's overnight because I don't have time to do it the same day. So it's okay, no worry, it's still gonna be good. So today we're gonna take it out and then we're gonna put under the normal fridge and then we'll take 1 hour. I leave it outside for about 5-7 minutes, you know, to get it a little bit soft, but not watery. Like, it's not, it's just a little bit soft enough for me to cut it in the small piece. All the meat before I get ground, it have to be cold. It cannot be melted, watery, or it cannot be soft and warm, because the meat had to be cold. So just put it outside about 5-7 minutes, and then you cut it out in a small piece like this. At the meantime, the other two is still in the in the fridge. So when you done, when you almost done the first one, you can take the second one out, and then continue, take turn to do one by one. So meat is still cold by the time get to the, you know, to the machine to get it ground. So make sure that you can leave overnight freezer, but you can do next day, but make sure the meat is have to be cold when, you know, when you go to put in the machine to grind the meat. So now we all cut small piece off, okay? And then we get ready to grind the meat now. So we put everything in the machine. Remember, at this time, the meat is still, some part is soft, some part is still icing, so that's good. So we're gonna grind about three times. Each time will be about 25 to 30 of the blade, like, moving around. So it doesn't take long. So after the first round, you know, you can stop the machine, and then, you know, clean it up around the bowl to make sure that all the meat is down, and then we're gonna start to redo it the second time. Remember, the meat is still very cold. That's what we want. We want the meat cold, so the taste will be better, and the result will be a lot better. Okay. So we do the second time, maybe 30 times of the plate, you know, turning. Okay, see, the meat now is getting, you know, very, how you call it? Very soft. Already, most of the meat already been grounded, but still, we're gonna do a little bit more. Okay, so I think that's it. So we're gonna see how the meat had to be looked like this when it's ready. So the next step after grind the meat, we're gonna smash the meat down on the any surface, like the chopboard, smash it down to make the meat more tough before get wrapped. Okay, so just smash few times. Just few times. When you do a couple times, then you will see how the meat look. And then when you look at the meat, you know that the pork sausage gonna be turn out very good when it's finished. See, you do the hand like this, and you can feel the sound. You know, bup, bup, bup. That means it's good. So now is the fun part, is how to wrap the meat with the banana leaf. So after we wash banana leaf, of course, we use two pieces of banana leaf. One place in the horizontal in the bottom, and one is vertical. And then you put a little bit of oil, place the meat in the middle. This is three steps to wrap the pork sausage with banana leaf. So the first step to folding both sides and folding down like this in the middle. We're going to use one short of this string for we call temporary string, because we're going to take it out after finish. We don't need it. The second step, folding one hand, hold up the how do you call it? Hold up the sausage. Cut the top part to make more clean, because we don't need all that banana leaf on the top. Okay, press down the meat a little bit to make it nice and clean in there. Yes, and folding both sides, make into a square look on the top. Doesn't have to be perfect, because we're gonna have the two little banana leaf long like this. We cut already one side to put in one end, and then turn around, we put another one on top. To doing this, we're gonna make a perfect nice square on the top. See how nice and clean now. Use elastic temporary to put on top one end, just like that. Turn away the other end, cut it up the extra banana leaf we don't use. Okay, cleaning up the meat, you know, press the meat down to make it nice and clean, just like that. Press it down to make sure nice, even, no messy. And then we're gonna fold in the same way with the other side, folding in the middle, make a little square. Doesn't have to be perfect, remember, because we're gonna have that magic, the last two little piece of banana leaf, one in one side, turn around the other side, we put another one on top. That's it. Voila, we have a nice and beautiful square look on the top, just like that. You another elastic, put on the top. There we go. We have a nice rectangular shape. That's before the wrapping finished yet. So at this time, you know, we're gonna spray out on the banana leaf there. Make sure it's nice and straight. And then we're gonna take out the temporary string at the first place when we put it in. Take it out, we don't need anymore. Save it for next time. Okay, make sure nice and clean before we make the third step final to tie it up. We're gonna use the string about 2 arm long, a little bit more. Wrap from the top, bring down to the bottom, make one knot, bring up straight, and we turn the other side down, just like that. Bring it down, and we're gonna tie the knot at the first, the first beginning start, the first start. So we start from the top like that. That's the one. That is the, and then wrap around and come back at the point, the first start point, right there. Okay, make the knot nicely. You do whatever to make sure it's nice and tight at the first knot. You can see how I'm doing, and then you can just do like that, or do whatever in your way to make it easy. Let's make the first knot to start. Now, the next step, we're gonna use the thumb, wrap around your thumb, wrap around like that, just like that. Wrap around your thumb, put it down, and wrap around the sausage. Put the string through the knot, through the hole where the arm, straight up there, and put it back. Pull up, pull back. Just like that. Next one, continue to make another wrap around your thumb. put it down the string, wrap around the banana, and then pull the string in the front, back, the front and back, front and back, just like that. See how nice and even? Continue, wrap around your thumb, pull the string around, put through the knot, the middle knot there, and put in the front, pull to the front, pull to back, pull to front, pull to back. That's it. Nicely done. Even. And to the end one, same thing. Put through, put the string through that hole from the thumb. Okay? Like that. Pull the string to the front and pull to the front, pull back, front and back. That's it. We're done. See? All nice and even. Very easy, very fast, isn't it? Okay, at the end, we just make another knot. Do whatever. Whatever you think is you can, you know, finish the knot and get out from that. So just make a nice little string maybe, you know, so when you pull it up, you don't be too hard on your hand. Yeah, just like this. Okay? Now we have a little extra string. You can cut it up. Okay, see how nice, very nice, even. Clean it up, cut it off the elastic band. We don't need any more. Remember the elastic band is from the onion when you bought at the grocery. So keep the elastic band for this use, this purpose, okay? Don't waste. So you can, you know, roll around a few times to make sure it's more round. Straighten up on the string to make sure nice and even. See, that's it. That's all you done. You have one nice, even, clean pork sausage wrapped by banana leaf. And then we're going to get it steamed after. See how nice? Beautiful, eh? And it looks delicious. I promise. So, this is very basic, very nice, easy step for you to do the wrapping. So we'll try to make a second time for you, you know, to see how easy to do it. See? So I hope you will follow it just step by step. You do one time, maybe not perfect, second time you're gonna get it. Okay, so we're going to do one more time for you, all right? Okay, so we're going to wrap one more time. So remember, one banana, about two of your hand, and then one horizontal, one vertical. Put the meat in the middle, okay? And then the first step, we're going to fold in both sides into the middle. Sometimes the banana leaf is not as good as today, but it's okay. We will make it, and we will make it nice. Wrap it down. Use the temporary string. Tie the knot in the middle. Okay, that's the first step. And then the second step, we fold in one end, lift up the sausage, cut off the top of the banana leaf. We don't need this extra. Okay, and press the meat down to make sure nice and even. All right. Okay, and then fold in the middle, both end down to make a little square on the top. It's not gonna be perfect. Don't worry, because we're gonna use that two piece of small banana leaf, one on the top, one side. Okay, press it down a little bit to make it a square. Turn the other side. We put another one on top. There we go. We make a nice little square on the top. So you won't see in the other worst part of banana. So elastic on the top. Turn the other side. Cut down the top of the extra banana leaf we don't use. Okay. Clean it up. Press down the meat. Make sure nice and clean. down there. Okay. You see how messy is a banana leaf, but you won't see it after. Okay, fold it in the middle. Make a 9-liter square on the top. That's okay. It doesn't have to be worried about this detail there, because this 2 pieces of banana leaf at the end will cover it up. There we go. Okay, press it down, turn, and put the last one on top. Ta-da! We have a nice little square one. Put elastic on the top. That's it. We're done to make a nice rectangular shape here. Okay? Now we're going to find the temporary string to take it out. We don't need that. Okay, after we take it out, we're gonna straight out on the banana leaf, make sure nice and straight, even, clean before we wrap it with the string. Remember, it's long, about 2 arms long, a little bit more. Start from the top, bring down to the bottom, make 1 knot. And bring it up, turn the other way, bring it down, and start a starting point at the one top, at the one place on the top, just like this one. See? Start from the from that point. Okay, wrap around, use the string wrap around the pork sausage. Tie the knot back at the center one where you start, okay? Make the nice knot there. Just tie the normal knot to make sure it's nice and clean. You can just wrap like this, okay? There we go. We're done for the starting point, okay? Cut the elastic now if you like, because we don't need it at the end anyway, so we take out the elastic band. Okay, then we're gonna start at the starting point down. Wrap around the string, wrap around your thumb, just like that. And then wrap around, put through the hole, pull the front and back. That's it. Continue follow with the next one. Wrap around, put through the hole, put the front, back. Just like that. Continue. Wrap around, put string through the hole, put in the front, back, and that's it. Last one. See, it only takes 4 minutes to finish one. 4 to 5 minutes. Okay, we tie the knot on the top to finish the procedure. Cut it off, the extra string we don't need. Now we turn it up. We tied it up the knot to make to finish the procedure before putting the steamer. At this time, the steamer is already on, okay? Start from when is the water boiling until it's cooked. It's about 30 minutes. Okay, cut the string. Ta-da! How nice, even, fast, and cute little one here. Very nice, and it tastes very yummy. After it steam 30 minutes, it cook, then you can just put in the fridge and use it and eat it with few different plates of Vietnamese dishes. There we go. We are done. I'm not gonna do the third one, so just for you to practice. So now these are the 3 pork sauces. Wrap with banana leaf, and after steam 30 minutes, it's all ready. I'm gonna cut one for you to see, okay? Still hot? Still hot, yes. Look at that, the smoky come out. It's so nice, yummy, chewy, soft, and very, very delicious. This is very tasty, clean, and cheap. $7 for the meat with all the ingredients. You can make 3 pork sauces. Yummy like this. You can eat with so many dishes of Vietnamese dishes. We have like rice roll cake or viet sup, many, many more. See how nice? Thank you very much for watching Lee Dynasty Kitchen today. I hope my video can share you the best way and fast way to make Vietnamese pork sauces with banana leaf. And I hope you enjoy it. And don't forget to share and subscribe to your friends, to your family, so everybody can enjoy it. Okay? And thank you very much for support Lee Dynasty Kitchen. And I hope to see you again with many, many more of different Vietnamese dishes. And together, we can add it on your kitchen with a lot of yummy, yummy, yummy recipes.